He's accused of murdering his Brazilian girlfriend in suburban Sydney. Now, Mario Santoro has faced court for the first time in Rio de Janeiro, sitting handcuffed as detectives dropped a startling revelation. They claim he confessed to killing Cecilia Haddad, then taunted her family with messages to cover up what he'd done.
A courtroom on the other side of the world hears an Australian murder bombshell, an alleged confession by accused killer Mario Santoro. Rio's homicide boss testifying that in an informal meeting, Santoro admitted to strangling Cecilia Haddad because he left rejected when she ended their relationship, telling the court he left her before returning 2 hours later and used a mattress or sack to cover her body that was cold and hard and put her in the car. The court heard Santoro use Cecilia's own diving weights to sink her in the Lane Cove River, then say prosecutors came a callous cover-up. Using Cecilia's dead finger to access her phone, he taunted her family, messaging her mother, "Dear Milo, my WhatsApp is not working right. He's not here. He's left his keys and is returning to Brazil on Tuesday. He misses his daughters. I'm going to spend some time in the mountains." Police allege Cecilia was already dead and that Santoro threw her keys off the Gladesville Bridge on his way to flee home to Brazil. But Santoro's legal team is already casting doubt on any confession.
He made Santoro feel comfortable and maybe seduced him into saying things. We don't even know if this conversation happened.
Their defense, it wasn't him.
Cecilia used dating apps to meet new people. So who's the criminal? Maybe a psychopath? Maybe her ex-husband who was in a legal battle with her?
Though New South Wales police say her ex wasn't even in the state when she died.
When the case goes to trial, a judge will decide if the media is allowed to record the court proceedings. Ultimately, seven jurors will decide Santoro's fate in this courtroom.
Brazilian police hope when they return in a month, Australian detectives will join them. In Rio de Janeiro, Ashley Brown, 7 News.